Go.
There we go. This 3-2-1 means it. Hey guys, welcome to B2TV. Again, super high tech carry behind the scenes. Head over. We'll have it on our Instagram story of exactly what I have to do to make my computer work to get not my forehead only on camera. It's good times. Hi guys.
Hello. happy Tuesday. Happy October. Oh, it's crazy.
Happy this is like the best month. It's so much fun. Like I'm a little, I'm kind of disappointed because I have yet to decide our Halloween costumes yet. Like not even for the pets. Like we have no costumes and it's the 2nd of October and I'm getting twitchy.
So we have an annual Halloween at our house. This is the 3rd annual year of our spooktacular event. And we always do like a couple of costumes. So the first year we were a piece of bacon and an egg. Last year we were Dorothy and the Scarecrow and Chloe was Toto. And I have no idea where we're going to be this year. I was thinking something with dinosaurs. I would love to do something with dinosaurs, but we'll see.
That'd be cool. I think we have, last year we ended up not dressing up for like the first time ever. But we do have a couple banana stand uniforms, so we may have to go back to being George Michael and maybe, just because we have the aprons. So we might be hanging out at the banana stand. I don't know.
I mean, if you we just shall like, see. Do a fashion show beforehand, can you send me those pictures?
Oh, absolutely. The costume deciding process is the best. So hi, welcome to Halloween Talk with Carrie and Brooke.
Favorite month. Halloween is my favorite holiday, quote unquote. Some people don't consider it a holiday. And my 3-year also wedding anniversary is next week, a week from tomorrow.
So happy. We might be almost spending your anniversary together, like a week off.
I know. It's like a week off. Yeah. And then, oh my God, that's so exciting about.
Then it's our anniversary, Brooke. The first time we've known each other for like, what, 6-7 years?
Yeah, it started with the Social Solutions Collective like 6 or 7 years ago. Funny, Jen Herman, I don't know if you saw on my Instagram, Jen Herman and I were hanging out. She came in town for the Agents of Change conference.
Yes, that was, hi Jen.
Yes, and she also was part of the Social Solutions Collective. So we were talking about like how we met and she actually tells the story from stage that she and I met on Instagram and kind of came together through the Social Solutions Collective. It's so funny how many of us are friends because of that.
I know. And it's like the last, what, year we've all been meeting in person. We met a year ago at Sprout. You met Jen for the first time in person at that event. It's just like crazy.
Oh, no, in San Diego.
San Diego. It just, you know, takes like 5 to 7 years to meet people that we know.
When we meet in real life, it's like we've known each other forever because we have. I mean, it's really not that much different.
I mean, cheese and jelly days, it goes way back.
So far back. Also,
But speaking of, we're going to see each other again. And the bonus of Jenny, our ads queen, the three of us are going to get together in person and hang out at the Sprout Agency Partner Conference in like 2 weeks. And I cannot wait.
I am so excited to meet Jenny. I already can tell she's like one of us. She's goofy, but she like gets the work done. I'm feeling it already. I can tell we're going to have so much fun and I'm so excited to meet her. And I'm excited to see all of our Sprout partners.
Yes. And any of you that are watching, if you're going to be there, let us know. We would love to, maybe we'll swing a meetup.
Yeah.
Depending on how that works. Or lunch.
Table at lunch.
We'll get the cool kids table going. It'll be great.
Yeah. So I think that would be really fun. And so tell everybody when Sprout, if they change it from Sprout Partner Day to Sprout Partner Summit, it's 2 days
Summit.
This year.
And it's at a museum, which is like super fun. It's going to be an Instagram heavy week for me. So pay attention. So I apologize in advance. So I will keep it all as much of my story as possible, but keep a watch because I'm trying to convince Brooke that we need to do one of these on an Instagram live, a live B2TV on Instagram from Chicago, because we'll be in the same room. So that's like a first.
Yeah, no, we definitely should. We should do like an Instagram live or I don't know, you know, all that stuff that I'm always like, anyway. Yeah, so it's been kind of a whirlwind 10 days for me. So it started with Jen came in town, Jen Herman, and she and I got to play for a day, and then Agents of Change happened, which is a wonderful conference up here in Portland, Maine. If you've never been, the fabulous Rich Brooks puts it on, and it's a small, but really, I just feel like, you know, because it's smaller, the networking is like huge at Agents of Change. I just really love that event. A lot of amazing people, amazing speakers. Then I drove home that night after the conference to New Jersey. And as some of you know, on Friday, I accepted my top 25 brand builder, woman brand builder. And
Yay!
So I'm really excited about that. Then the next day, some of you saw this on Instagram, I got my headshots done with a fabulous photographer. So keep a lookout for those coming out. And then the following week, I drove to Lancaster, Pennsylvania, where I spoke at the Insight Conference in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. Insight Lanc was the hashtag. Again, if you followed on Instagram, there were some amazing speakers again, and really fabulous networking. It's like another smaller conference. I'd say like 300, 350 people, but the networking was so great. I mean, that's what's so great about these small conferences is I feel like you get that one-on-one with people that sometimes you don't get at some of the bigger conferences. So I really liked that. So anyway, that has been my 10-day whirlwind tour.
And Brooks Ellis Road Warrior.
This will be my last live here from Boothay Harbor as we are leaving because sadly summer is over and I really do want to cry. I'm just so sad to leave. But I'll see you guys from New Jersey on the next one. Or maybe Chicago and then New Jersey.
You get around, girl. You're everywhere.
Yeah.
Which almost leads us into another infamous Carrie really bad segue. It's going to be hard to get organized when you come back from all that time on the road.
it's a nightmare. I tried to keep up with email while I was out, but I also had my aways on. And I'm like 2 days behind on some of the follow-up that I had due 2 days ago in base camp, which I know you'll bring up. Being organized is very important, and I try to be organized, but it's hard sometimes without the assistance of tools.
Well, and it's Get Organized Week, which I didn't know was a holiday, but it is the holiday of my people. My mother has this saying, if you want to know the easiest way to do something, ask the laziest person in the room. I've changed that to, if you want to know the most organized way to do something, ask the most unorganized person in the room. I will hand raise that.
I'll be the most organized.
I have to be uber organized because I'm off in like 1,000 different directions in my brain, but tools save me and make me look like I'm really, really organized. And thankfully, hopefully, well, timely enough, it sounds like you got a lot of questions about tools at your last couple speaking or engagements and talked a lot about that.
Yeah, I did. So I spoke on the 5 social media must-have processes, which is not a sexy subject until you realize that having these processes down pat saves you time and saves you money, which is totally sexy. and P.S., if you're listening, I guess I'll go ahead and give you our free swipe file. So I had a swipe file that I gave away in the talk. So if you're listening today, I will give you the swipe file. Just head over to bsquared.media/swipe, SWIPE file, file, and it actually has those 5 must-have processes. But essentially, people started asking questions like, "Hey, this is a lot of work," which we know because this is what we do every day, right? But they were like, "How do you guys manage to get this all done?" And I was like, "Well, quite honestly, tools." So they were kind of started asking for some suggestions of tools. Trello is a tool that I used to use when it was more me and less, you know, team oriented. I love Trello. Did you ever use Trello?
I have not actually. I've only, a lot of the tools I've used have been the ones for multiple people. Like Slack, we don't use here, but I have used one of our clients uses it, and I use it a lot with a couple of friends as a alternate work chat to a work chat and in a previous agency. but I live in Basecamp. That's where everything has to be.
Basecamp is our homie.
Yeah. Yeah, it's, and I am total shout out to them on Instagram yesterday. We wouldn't be organized without you. I honestly don't know how people who work in a virtual situation like us, because obviously look behind us, we are not in the same room. How people that work in this kind of situation and virtually, how you could be organized without a tool. And Basecamp is such a lifesaver. It tracks everything. We can have private chat and public chat and clients, and
it's so cost effective. So I give Basecamp a huge shout out in my process of speech, and everybody's like, "Oh, it sounds expensive." I'm like, "I think we pay like $80 a month or something. Unlimited projects, unlimited team members. We pay for what has also the client side, so we can bring clients into the workspace and they can see all of our workflows and checklists and whatnot. So with client side, I think it's like $80 a month. But if you don't have the need to bring clients in, I think it's like $50 a month or something like that. I mean, so it's nominal. Our business is built on this tool. So I think, yeah, it's a no brainer tool if you are trying to get organized.
Yeah. And then so that I actually have the, this is where I'm a dork. I have the personal Basecamp as well that I got for myself. And that's how I did. Just recently moved this year, and our moving process and a lot of our renovation process I've been putting into Basecamp at home to keep on track.
Trello's free. I mean, I know you love Basecamp, and I do. Trello's free. It's like basically like got little like boards, so you could like, it's like getting bids in progress, like completion date, follow up, or whatever. Like, it's almost like a pipeline. You can like build certain like areas, and you just drag and drop your little like tasks over.
Oh, that sounds fun.
Yeah. And then, I mean, cause I'm one of those people who like, when I used to write my list down, if I didn't write something on the list, but then went through and completed it, I would have to go back, write it down to cross it off. Like, it's so satisfying to like see your task like get crossed off in Basecamp or in Trello, like go to like the done pile.
There's nothing better than like slashing off a list. I still like to write lists by hand just so I can cross stuff off. But that's me. That's just a little overly satisfying. Just boom, done.
Well, and I would be remiss if we didn't talk about Nimble too. So I did a webinar with them not too long ago, and that's kind of how, as the you're looking at the sales team for B Squared. That's how we really manage all of our contacts and our sales pipeline. So that does have like a pipeline where it's like prospecting, free consultation, proposal sent, follow up. And then I actually just built a fifth section of the pipeline that's like holding pattern, because for whatever reason, we've never needed it before, but here lately we've come across some clients who need a little bit more time. So I kind of built in that fifth area as a holding pattern so that I'm not taking people out of the pipeline, but I'm kind of like saying, hey, they're not ready at this time. So Nimble, fantastic. And another fantastically priced tool. I want to say I pay like $25 a month for Nimble.
$30. Oh, that's not bad at all.
And both Nimble and Basecamp have a 30-day free trial. So, and there's no like affiliate links or anything. Like, we're just like mentioning them because we're good people. And if they want to send us swag, here we are.
Oh, I think we're always down for swag. As I like just finished drinking out of my Sprout water bottle and put it back in the kitchen.
I actually have one here and one here. Yeah. I'm like obsessed with those water bottles. Anyway, what else?
And speaking of Sprout and tools, when I don't know how I would get done in a day, managing all my accounts and touching all of them every day without Sprout. I would literally be like setting timers for myself going, okay, you have to go post on Twitter for this client and Facebook for this client at this time. And, oh, and go check and see if anyone's messaged them. And I think I would go completely insane, actually. Sprout puts everything, just funnels everything you need into one screen. and you just have your little tabs for publishing and community management, and it just keeps you, again, it forces the organization upon you in the best possible way.
Well, I have to call out Sprout too for their innovation. So they're like constantly like working on the tool. So the tool is constantly getting better, but I would say like some like three things, but if I were gonna call it three things about Sprout that I love: Smart Inbox, which is like where all of your notifications hit one inbox. And then you have all of these little like toggles, basically you can turn on and off. So like if you want all of your platforms, like Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, all coming into that Smart Inbox, you can have them all show up in one place. Or if that's overwhelming, you could toggle off Twitter. Or, you know, I just like how customizable the Smart Inbox is. I would have to
call. And you can do keywords too. It's not just like direct platform, direct mentions. It's anybody who might be saying something about something relevant to something you want to respond to. Like you can look up anything.
Yeah. And then viral post, which they used to only have viral posts for Twitter, which is when you schedule your tweets for the client or for yourself. Essentially, you can let it go in the queue, which viral post takes care of. And Sprout will put it out at the times that are most likely to get attention and clicks, engagement. And then they just added that for Facebook recently, which I love. So now you can use viral posts for both Facebook and Twitter, which, again, I just think like it's taking the guesswork out, right? So anything that can make our lives easier. Again, it takes some serious organizational skills to go in every day and try to figure out your best time.
There's nothing like that little 5-star, oh, this is the best time to post on Tuesday. Yes. Boom, let's put that there.
That is sexy social, man. Mm-hmm. And then the third thing I think I would call out, oh, chatbots. Sneak peek for y'all. We are going to be releasing Done For You chatbot services here pretty soon. And Sprout is helping us do that. They help you build an array of chatbots inside of the platform so that you can help with lead generation. If you're in e-commerce, if you want like content to be shared, they have all of these like pre-built chatbots. And then you could also build custom chatbots based on natural language processing. So it's just really cool. It's AI. It's AI maybe. So you don't have to be like a total like nerd and data scientist to understand how to do AI.
I would be remiss to talk about any conversation about Sprout without going, oh, but the tags. I'm kind of a fan of tags on Sprout, which if anyone's spoken to me about Sprout ever, will probably know that. It just gives you such data that you can come to a client or the client can go to their boss with hard facts versus gut feelings. You can say, hey, you know, I really think people are talking about oysters because I see the picture behind Brooke. People are really into oysters right now. And you can say that. That's a gut feeling. Yeah, okay, that's what I think. Or you could say 25% of our conversation this week was about oysters.
Right.
You know, it really allows you to tell a story with numbers behind it. And I love it. Love it. Love it so much.
That helps you drive so much, though. Like obviously, our tagline is think conversation, not campaign, but it's true. If you're looking at the conversation and you see that boost in oysters is happening, then you can put the campaign behind it. So add some paid media, throw in a coupon, whatever it may be, because you already know that spike in our share of volume has gone up around oysters. So it's a good time to start doing something with oysters with your own content on social.
And I think that is something that's going to have to be added to our B2TV bingo card when I get around to making it, as Carrie brings up tags. I think that's going to be like the free space right in the middle.
Yeah.
If this didn't happen at noon, I'd say it'd be a drinking game, but let's make it bingo instead just to keep it safe.
Let's keep it lunchtime friendly.
Exactly.
What else? What else do we owe Harvest?
Yes. Honestly. To know what you're doing when you're doing it. Because half the time you'll be switching from client project this to client project that to the other, or, hey, I need to stop and do this right away. And if you don't keep track of that, for a while before I knew about Harvest, I had a calendar on my wall and I would write on post-it notes I worked on this thing for this many minutes and put the post-it note on the calendar. And then at the end of the day, I would total up. And it was, I mean, I, you know, probably raised post-it note stock by like 20%, but it wasn't really useful or positive or accurate.
Horrible.
And somewhere I have a picture of it. Yeah, yeah.
A different timer before, a different app, a lot more user-friendly, I feel.
Yep, and it integrates into Basecamp directly. And it's just, you just click a button on your to-do and it does it. It's so cool. It's just like, boop, I'm clocked in. Yeah. Boop, I'm on this project now. And if you can do something with a boop, I love it.
Yeah, the boop.
It's all about the boop.
Yeah, so no, I think that's another great tool. I'm trying to think if there's any other. Obviously, we use a lot of file sharing, but we do it through Office 365. So, and that integrates with Nimble, which is fantastic. What other tools? What about
and so shout out to Dropbox too. I mean, that's a it's something we don't use here, but it's always a good one to use.
Definitely, it's easy to use. And fantastic. But what about some like social? I've been hearing some good things lately from friends of ours in the social space. Chris Penn and Katie, they are with Brain Trust Insights, and they love TalkWalker, which I know TalkWalker from back in the day, but apparently they really upped their game. And now they're putting out a lot of their work on predictive analytics with charts from TalkWalker.
Ooh.
So, yeah. So the charts are really pretty, which is kind of a big deal in our world. That's another thing about Sprout. They're pretty reports.
Pretty data.
So pretty. Yeah. Which is kind of a big deal. I mean, you can download the raw data if the client wants it in a specific way with Sprout. But like I would say 99.5% of the clients want the pretty report. It's so easy to understand what's going on. And it's pretty.
Yeah. Now all we need for them, and if Sprout guys are listening, here's a, I always take the tag data, mark your bingo card. I always have to take the tag data and manually turn that into charts and graphs on my own. But if we can come up with a way to download a pie chart of tag reporting, I am in to test it. I'm willing. I'm able. Guys, let's talk. I'll see you in 2 weeks.
Are you on the Sprout Slack channel?
Yeah.
Okay, you should put that.
See, there's another way reason to use Slack. Get a
with Sprout with a client. I use it with Brain Trust Insights on some collaborations we're working on. So I love Slack too. But I do feel like, I mean, I'm not gonna lie, if somebody said you had to choose between Slack and Basecamp, I would choose Basecamp.
Basecamp.
Slack is like a glorified communication channel. It's like the glorified ping, but like we have, I feel like we have so many more bells and whistles inside of Basecamp that I.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, if I had to choose, I would definitely choose that. I mean, you could do Google IM for that too. You know, it's like, but it is nice. It is helpful. But yeah, Basecamp over Slack.
Definitely. Right.
But if there's any tools anybody else has that they want to drop in the comments, we would love to see your ideas, what you use, what tools you love, what tools you can't live without, what tools you wish existed would be kind of a cool one to see too.
Yeah. Oh, you know, I guess we could talk about, hang on, I'm just making sure nobody. Design Pickle. So we do use Canva. And when we need something like basic and we're comfortable with our own design chops, but we also outsource to, it's a tool really, it's an app called Design Pickle, and it's unlimited designs. You know, it has like a little asterisk, like there's some limitations, but it's unlimited designs, and you can actually have a designer put together the designs that you need. And that's, I think, a good time saver for us, especially on some of the more difficult designs that we need. What else? What else do we have to have? How we live by? I think it's like I think we mentioned them all, really. I mean,
I think so.
But we try not to get too like shiny object syndrome either, because I mean, if we were using 30 tools, it starts to get a little bit messy and hard to keep up with. So we really try to be as efficient as possible. So even your organizing needs to be organized.
If there's too many to put on the home screen of your phone, then you have too many tools.
Yeah. Yeah. And, oh, you know what? I would like to put a question out. If you're listening and you feel like leaving a comment, leave me some of your ideas for two-factor, I hate the word, two-factor.
I can't say it either.
I do it every time.
Authentication.
Yes. I don't know why that's so hard to say. Two-factor authentication. If you have any tools that you love that work with two-factor authentication, drop it in the comments below with a link and we'll be sure to check it out because that's something we're definitely doing a lot more research around.
Yeah, that would be awesome. We'd love the suggestions. So I think on that, we'll leave you guys with homework unless there's anything else.
No, I think that's it for me.
All right. Those are our tools. We'd love to see yours. And don't forget to head over to our Instagram stories to see the super high tech and B2 TV. Bye,
everybody.
All right, bye, everybody.
See you next time.